gentleman was he. He climbed up in a sycamore tree for the Lord he wanted to see. And as the Savior passed that way, he looked up in the tree. And he said, "Zacchaeus, you come down. For I'm going to your house today. For I'm going to your house today."
Welcome back to another week of CET Kids. We'll have a fun show for you tonight again. I'm going to open in prayer now before we get started. Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us all back this week again. Help us enjoy all the songs and the actions and to listen to the story from your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, boys and girls, we're going to go straight into our first two courses. The first is going to be Stephen and Grace. And then we're going to go over to Andrew.
Hi, boys and girls. Where do we get the music going?
Oh. He made the stars shine. He made the rolling sea. He made the mountains high. And he made me. And this is why I love you. For me, he bled. The Lord of all creation became the crucified. He made the stars to shine. He made the rolling sea. He made the mountains high. And he made me. And this is why I love you. For me he bled. The Lord of all creation became the crucified.
Now, boys and girls, where do we stop that?
Hi, everybody.
And now we're going to see who isn't doing the actions. Come on, let's see. Come on, Steve-o, up you get. Ready, boys and girls, we're going again. Ready, everybody?
Hey boys and girls, I have my favourite song here, it's The Lord's Army, and if you know me, I love this song, so I want to get these all up on your feet, stand tall, shoulders back, and get ready for The Lord's Army. Let's get ready to march.
I will never march in the
See you, boys and girls. Bye.
Aren't they good songs and fantastic actions as well? So I'm sure you're ready now for a wee break. So let's settle down nice and calm and quiet for this week's story. We'll have somebody different doing our story this week. Can anybody guess who it might be? Nope. I think maybe one of you might have got it right there. So we're going to go over to Denise this week for the story. Over to you, Denise.
I need to go to the shop and get some money to get some chocolate and some juice for myself tonight after CET Kids. Hold on! CET Kids? I'm in store tonight! You sure they're already waiting on me? I'm a silly Billy. I forgot me and I put all my money and bank cards and all away to get this story started. So the story tonight is found in Luke 19. And it's about a man caught the case. So, in a beautiful city called Jericho lived a tax collector called Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus was very rich, but most of his money came from cheating people, collecting more money than he rightly should have. In the taxes, all the Jews hated the tax collectors. Zacchaeus had no friends because of his job. This is because he did collect more than he should have. So he did. That would be like me earlier going to the shop and buying all the stuff I needed and them charging me more. They would have been stealing my money, so they would have. So one day, as Zacchaeus sat alone, he heard all this commotion and sound outside, and he wondered what that sound, what it was all about, because it never happened before, I don't think. So he got up, left whatever he was doing, and went outside to find out what it was. And what it was that Jesus was passing through the streets of Jericho. And as Zacchaeus listened to the excitement in their voices, Jesus is passing through! Jesus is passing through! So Zacchaeus, I was like, I wonder what Jesus looks like. Jesus doesn't look any different from me and you. But there is one difference. Jesus was born with no sin. Jesus was born like God, who has no sin. We were born with sin because Adam and Eve sinned in the Garden of Eden. And we were born with sin, and Jesus was sent for us so that we could have a relationship and be with God. So, as Jesus entered the city of Jericho, Zacchaeus tried to see, but he had this wee problem. He was too short. That would be like you trying to see over your mummies or daddies, standing behind them, and you're trying to see what was going on. If you had went to, say you went to the zoo, and there was this big crowd, and you couldn't see, sure you couldn't. So sometimes you would be lifted up so you could see the animals. Well, this is a bit like Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus couldn't see, but nobody would lift him up, because he was maybe too heavy to lift up, but nobody would ever let him up to the front. This was because nobody liked them. So they're like, no, you're not going to the front. And this didn't stop Zacchaeus, because suddenly Zacchaeus had this brilliant idea. And I wonder what this brilliant idea was. Well, suddenly he started to run super fast down the street and just suddenly stopped under a sycamore tree. And he looked up and he thought to himself, I could climb this tree. He maybe climbed before. But so he started to climb up this tree and got himself maybe comfy sitting on a branch, which I don't think would be very comfy, but he was up it and he was able to see Jesus walking down the street towards where he was. And as Jesus walked down the street, suddenly he stopped under the tree and looked up, just Zacchaeus, and shouts, Zacchaeus, come down! Because I'm going to your house today. Well, Jesus said this, not in a hateful way, but in a loving way. In a loving way that Jesus is. Because he loves every single one of us, no matter what we've done. No matter how far we have wandered from God, Jesus still loves us. And Zacchaeus was sitting there. Nobody ever wants to go to my house. And suddenly he realized that Jesus wanted to go to his house. And Zacchaeus scrambled down the tree and dropped right beside the Lord Jesus. And I'm sure you're wondering how Jesus knew where Zacchaeus was and knew Zacchaeus' name. Well, this is because Jesus knows everything about every single one of us. He even knows that you're sitting maybe in the living room with your feet up with a wee cup of juice and a wee crisp chocolate bar, a wee bag of crisps, watching this tonight. But that's okay. And he even knows if mummy or daddy or somebody has told you not to steal a wee chocolate bar before dinner because you might need your dinner. But mummy, they mightn't find out, but Jesus knows that and you have just sinned. And that's not, Jesus doesn't like sin, but he loves you, and this is why he died on the cross. And this is why he has came to see Zacchaeus today. So boys and girls, no matter what you've done, Jesus still loves you. So as Zacchaeus dropped down, he was super happy, but the people in the crowd, they were like, does Jesus even know that he's gone to a house of a sinner, a thief and a cheat? Well, I didn't. Jesus did know, because as I told you there, Jesus knows everything and Jesus loves every single body. And it does tell us in the Bible that we are all born of sin, but that doesn't stop Jesus from loving us. Jesus will love us no matter what we've done, if we repent and turn away from our bad, from all the wrong things we've done. So as he murdered, this didn't stop Jesus from looking to go to Zacchaeus' house. And I wonder, it doesn't say, but I think he maybe got his servants to make a lovely dinner for the Lord Jesus as they talked and stuff. And it doesn't tell us what it says in the Bible. It doesn't say in the Bible what the Lord Jesus and Zacchaeus talked about. But it does tell us that it changed his life forever. So it did. He told the Lord Jesus that he would give half of his goods to the poor and give back four times as much that he stole. And everyone was shocked when Zacchaeus started to give. Instead of going, I want your money. I want your money. Jesus, Zacchaeus was like, there's your money back. There's more. There's your money back. There's your money back. There's your money back. And this was because Jesus said, salvation has came to your house. That simply means that he was saved and Zacchaeus was doing the right things. Let me start that again. Jesus said, today salvation has came to your house. This is just like the memory verse that we're going to, which you will learn later in the program. And it's found in Luke 19, verse 10, Jesus has came to seek and to save that which was lost. These were the best words that Zacchaeus has ever heard. Jesus has rescued him from his sin and from being lost and separated from God. Jesus brought Zacchaeus back to God. He now trusts God and belongs to him. Zacchaeus would never ever be lost again. Boys and girls, that's a bit like us. If we realize that we are sinners and we deserved to be punished for our sins, but God thought different. God thought he would send his own son to die for us so that we didn't have to be punished for our sins and that we could be saved. The Lord Jesus can do that, do the same thing for you than he did for Zacchaeus. And just like the memory verse was, the Son of Man came to seek and to save that which was lost. We could put our name in there, so we could. The Son of Man came to seek and to save whoever your name, whatever your name is, because he's came to seek and to save you, because he loves you so much and he wants you to be saved and not to go to that awful place called hell that we don't like to talk about, but it's there. He wants you to be up in heaven with him. So boys and girls, Jesus didn't spend too long in Jericho. He had one special reason to be heading to Jerusalem. He was going to be punished for our sins on that cross so that he could save us, that he could rescue us from our sins. Just like he rescued Zacchaeus, he can do the same thing for you, and he has done the same thing for the Lighthouse, or the CET Kids leaders that come faithfully every week to bring songs to you, to bring the memory first, to bring the story. Boys and girls, we all love you and we all would love to see you safe, but that the only person who can save you is Jesus. The leaders can't, but if you ever need to speak to us, we're here. All you have to do, get your mummy or daddy to send a wee text message to the church Facebook page and we will speak to you. We all love you, and boys and girls, just realise that Jesus loves you more than anyone will ever love you, and that he has came to save that which was lost. That's me and you. Thank you for listening. Bye.
That was brilliant, Denise. Very good. Zacchaeus was one of my favourite stories whenever I was wee. And every time I seen a tree, I always thought, is that the tree Zacchaeus was up? So we're going to go over now to Paul, and then we're going to go over to Donna for another couple of songs, and we'll get some actions done, get ourselves stretched out after sitting so well during that story. Over to you guys.
Boys and girls, this is Ask Seek Knock, so we're going to do some actions. So everybody up on their feet, we'll do some actions.
And this is what it says to me. Tells me that I'm never ever alone. I'm learning how Jesus can come to us and give his best. Without a doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. Our God knows exactly what I need. So I remember this. Let's go! When you ask, he cares. When you see, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. When you ask, he cares. When you see, he's there. When you knock, 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 God opens up the door. Oh, oh. I'm reading my says to me, it tells me that I'm never ever alone. I'm learning how Jesus can come to us and give his best. Out of doubt, the best friend you'll ever know. But our God knows exactly what I need, so I remember this.
Everybody, thank you. Back over to the knees. Bye.
Hi, boys and girls. Tonight we're going to sing The Wise Man Built His House. So if you'd like to all get up on your feet.
That was brilliant. Now it's time to sit down and have another wee bit of a break, because we're going to go over to Sean and Chloe with this week's memory verse.
Boys and girls, are you all ready for your memory verse? Your memory verse tonight is found in Luke chapter 19, verse 10. And it says, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost."
Boys and girls, the Son of Man, who is the Lord Jesus Christ, has come to save the lost, meaning the lost sinners. And for you to get to heaven is to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your own and personal Saviour.
Well, I think now we will have a wee go at everybody saying it. So you check that wee bit. Hope you can all see it. And we're going to go over, and I want you all to say it yourselves, okay? So after three, one, two, three. The Bible says in Luke chapter 19, verse 10, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." That's very good, boys and girls. I think maybe we'll take away some words. Right, let's see. We will take away a few words. We'll try this one. So when it comes to the blanks, you have to shout out loud, really loud, okay? After three. One, two, three. The Bible says in Luke chapter 19, verse 10, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." That's really good. That's very good. Now I think we will take away quite a few of the words. So let's see if you can say it now, okay? And fill in all the blanks. All right. So after three, one, two, three. The Bible says in Luke chapter 19, verse 10, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." That's very good, boys and girls. And I think we'll put a few words back in, and I think we'll do it again. So this time I want you to really, really shout out loud, shout so loud that your parents have to go give you a treat, okay? So shout it really loud, and then they'll have to give you a big treat. All right, after three. One, two, three. The Bible says in Luke chapter 19, verse 10, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." That's very good, boys and girls. Make sure you get a big treat. Not a wee one, has to be a big treat. See you next week.
Bye.
That was brilliant. Thank you, Sean and Chloe. Now we're going to finish with two of CET Kids Live's favourites, and also Friday Night's Lighthouse favourite songs. It's Be Like a Tree and, of course, My Lighthouse. See you in a mo.
In my wrestling and in my doubts, in my failures, you won't walk out. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. Whoa, you are the peace in my troubled sea. In the silence, you won't let go. In the questions, your truth will hold. Your great love will lead me through. You are the peace in my troubled sea. You are the peace in my troubled sea. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness, I will follow you, Lord. My lighthouse, I will trust the promise, you will carry me safe to shore.
That was brilliant. Well done, everybody. That's the end of this week's programme, and hope to see you all back next week for more songs, memory verses, and of course another story. I'm going to close now in prayer, and we'll see you all next week. Heavenly Father, thank you for another week of CET Kids Live. Thank you for the fun we have had and the messages we have learned through your word and through the memory verse. Keep us all safe and bring us all back again together to listen and watch along next week. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye, see you next week.